Welcome to my new video making of my computer rebuilding system. There's a few fans and components. I'm now showing the old case of stripping it out. So I remove the covers first. I'm going to take those old fans out the top and replace them with two new red ones. So now is the stage where I just need to take all the components out first, the cards out, and then eventually get the board out and be able to start swapping components. So the board I use for this project is obviously the M5A99FX Pro, and the R2 version supports SLI, Windows 8 ready FX chipset. It's a nice board. It's basically the one that's below the Sabertooth one, but it's still pretty advanced for the average user. So now it comes in a static bag like this, and you get some accessories. There's the board itself laid out. It's very nice. It's like I said, it's a happy medium board. It's for a semi-advanced user. It has a good functions on it. Supports the AM3 Plus socket set for backwards compatible with some older chips that basically I'm still using, the Theming 2. So I reuse that one. But the board is outstanding. I love the quality. Main feature on what it was that it supports the PCI Express x16 dual, so you got SLI cards, and comes with nice features as well. It's got USB 3, SATA 3 with 6 gigs per second. It's still got your old ports there for your mouse keyboard, and you've got USB 3 boost ones there, yeah, eSATA. Lots of USB 2s, and you've got obviously your LAN and your 8.1 audio output, the back panel. So now, that one there I'm just showing, that's the fifth port for your SATA 3 output, and you've got your SATA 3 header as well, and it has some nice headers facing the right direction there. There's 6 there. It's running 2 different chipsets, 4 white ones are the main ones for data, your hard drives, everything. The blue ones are just data only. Showing that's a cube connector. Then there's you've got a Thunderbolt one there, just to the right of those USB 2 headers. And that big one there, that's a TPM, which that stands for Trusted Platform Module. Okay, so now we're just fast forwarding through, and I'm ready to take out the old components, which obviously start with disconnecting the power, taking out the graphics cards, stripping it out, and they're laid out. Is a new board ready, prepping it, the old one out. So it's basically a component swap system now. So you just got to be very careful and write details down now, like all your memory speeds and everything. Well, there's my empty case ready, prepped. Got my 2 new fans in the top there. Nice fans, red, 120mm. Obviously, you've got my new CPU installed. Cleaned it all up with some mess, select brush cleaner mess, which I just show here, and also clean the face of the back of the heatsink and prep it, and then I'll use a new thermal grease, only a very small amount, and attach it. The AM3 system is very good for heatsinks. There's no stupid plates or brackets, it's just very simple. With that heatsink fan comes the Zelman, very nice. So everything installed there, the memory, the fan, obviously the CPU was first. Make sure you plug in your CPU. Very important to the header now, before you forget, and very careful, but you have to be pretty firm, press the memory. You got to put it in your sequence. So here we're now showing the boards in. Put the graphics cards back in. Obviously when you put the board in, first you have to put your I.O. shield in. And I'm just showing there, they've got the 8-pin connector ATX that comes out the back of the board. It's pretty tight, but it's okay. And make sure your connection, the cable, is not going to interfere with the fan. And then start fixing all your power cables, your headers for your SATA drives, your power for your graphics cards, your SLI bridge, and all the audio front panel. Put that in first, and the headers before the graphics cards. Those are actually showing the old hard drives. I put new ones in later. So, and this is now up and running. I reinstalled new copy of Windows 7 64-bit Home Premium, and so yeah, that's all running now. And like I said, I'm going to do another review, but I did put in a SSD for Windows and a normal hard drive. Thank you for watching. Bye.